Hello and welcome to the 10th video lecture of Quantitative Techniques, Semester 3, Module Number 1. In today's video lecture, we are going to continue with Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation problems. Students, till now, we have seen some problems that can come in your examination for 10 mark section. Today, we shall discuss some problems or we shall see some problems, how to solve them, which can come in 2 mark section or 5 mark section. So let us begin. So your first question, which we are discussing for 5 mark section, is this. Here in this problem, instead of giving an entire table of values of x and y, they have given you ready-made values, what you normally calculate, that is summation xy, sigma xy that is, and summation y, summation x square, summation y square, and the value of n. And what they have asked you is, they have asked you to find out the coefficient of correlation. So instead of giving you any values like x, y, these kind of what you used to get in a previous problems, and you used to calculate something called x, y, then you used to calculate x squared, and then you used to calculate y squared. Sorry for the handwriting. So this is what you used to calculate, and here you used to get all sigma x, sigma y. So they have given this. The value of sigma x is 15, the value of sigma y is 200 here, and the value of sigma xy is given here, that is 500. Then the value of sigma x squared, what you will get here at the bottom, that is given as 98. The value of sigma y squared, that is the total of all this, is given as 23,250. And the total number of observation, that is n, how many values you have considered here, that is n is equals to 10. So all these values have been readymadely calculated and given to you. So such kind of problem can come in 5 mark section, because they have done lot of calculation. Now you are supposed to only substitute and find out the value of coefficient of correlation. So let us do it. Now the coefficient of correlation, that is Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, small r, is equal to, the formula we know it, n into summation xy minus summation x into summation y, the whole divided by n into summation x square minus summation x the whole square into n into summation y square minus summation y the whole square. Now in this formula, I have split this square root sign under two different headings, but you can use the same formula which we had used previously, that is entire thing can come in one square bracket only, as one square root itself. This way you can use it, there's no harm. The problem, it is one and the same, two different ways of writing it. You can use this way, like what we have used in a previous problems. Okay, you'll get the same answer. This is just way of writing, different way of writing. Some authors prefer to write it this way, some authors prefer to write it under one square root itself. So whichever way you use it, your answer will be right. So now what we are supposed to do here is, we are supposed to only substitute here. The value of n is 10, summation xy, so n is 10, then summation xy is 500, here they have given here. You can just check, summation xy is 500. Similarly, summation x into summation y, that is summation x is 15 and summation y is 200. Summation x is 15 and summation y is 200. Similarly, you can substitute here also bottom, that is square root of n is 10 into summation x square is 98, here you are getting, minus summation x the whole square, So summation x the whole square, that is summation x is 15. Okay, where is it? Here it is given. So all these values are given. You need to only substitute all these values which they have given here into here. So R is equal to this much. So just multiply 10 into 500 is 5000 minus 15 into 200 is 3000, the whole divided by 10 into 98. Here you can see 10 into 98. So 10 into 98, here you will get it is equal to minus 15 square. So 10 into 98 is 980 minus 15 square is 225. So 980 minus 225, you will get something. Find the square root of that, you will get 27.48. How have you got this 27.48? 980 minus 225, the square root of that. So that is 27.48. Similarly, here what you will get is 10 into 23,250, that is 232,500 minus 40,000. So whatever you get, square root of that, you will get 438.75. So 5000 minus 3000 is 2000 here, and here 27.48 minus 27.48 minus 438.75, you will get this much, that is 12,056.85. If you divide this, you will get the answer as 0.1659. So this is your answer, 0.1659. Now always I have told you, you have to end the problem with a comment. Now what will be the comment? This is a positive number, so it is positive correlation, and it is less than 0.7, it is less than 0.5, it is a very weak correlation. So these kind of correlation do not have any meaning at all, but just for understanding or knowing what is the correlation, so the we calculate this. So what is the comment, final comment, what you have to write? The comment is, it shows weak positive correlation or very weak positive correlation. Any of this you can write, weak positive correlation, WEAK, weak positive correlation or very weak positive correlation. So this is how you have to solve. This can come for 5 mark section. So I hope you understood this problem. We will take one more problem of another type, little different it is, because we are using a little different formula for that. Now let us begin that for this. I hope this method is clear here. Hardly anything, you just needed to substitute and find the value. Okay, so your next problem goes like this. In fact, we have two problems. Now you need to understand this problem and you need to note down the formulas also, because entire thing is dependent on formula. This can come in 2 mark section. Few times it was asked previously. What they have given here, they have given standard deviations of x and y, that is standard deviation of x is 5 and standard deviation of y is 9. So standard deviation is denoted by sigma, Greek letter sigma. So standard deviation of x is sigma x, that is 5, and standard deviation of y, that is sigma y, is 9. Then if the covariance, they have given covariance, how do you write covariance? COV and into bracket, between which two variables? Between x and y. So bracket, you write those two variables separated by a comma. Covariance of xy is equal to 8. They have mentioned that the covariance is 8. So what all the things they have given? They have given you sigma x value, they have given you sigma y value, and they have given you the covariance between x and y. So what is the formula to find out Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation? If you know only these three, If you know only these three, you can easily find out the Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. The formula for that is Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation is equal to covariance between x and y divided by sigma x into sigma y. So here covariance you know, sigma x you know, sigma y you know, you just need to substitute the values as it is. Covariance is given between the two variables is 8, standard deviation of two variables of those two variables are 5 and 9 respectively. So 8 divided by 5 and 9 into 9, so 8 by 45, so the answer is 0.1778. So I hope you are getting this answer by calculators. 0.1778. Again, the comment is very important here. What is the comment? Again, similar type of answer we are getting. So your comment will be also similar. It shows weak positive correlation. What is the comment? It shows weak positive correlation. I hope you understood this problem. This was very easy. Only thing is formula you need to mug up. You should know this formula. What is the formula to find out the coefficient of correlation? When you know the covariance and standard deviations, coefficient of correlation R is equals to covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. Okay, now what is the twist they can do here? Instead of giving you the values of sigma x and sigma y, so instead of giving you the values of sigma x and sigma y here, what they may give you is they may give you the value of something known as variance. So we know that variance is nothing but sigma square, or in short, if you want to find out sigma for any variable, that is sigma x for example, if you want to find out, then it is nothing but square root of variance. Square root of variance of x. So sigma x is equal to square root of variance of x, and similarly sigma y is equal to square root of variance of y. So if they give you variance, this is how you have to find out variance of y. Okay, so this is how you have to find out. Always you have to write comment in the end. Never forget to write the comment. Okay, always comment. So this can come for 2 mark section. This has already been asked a few times, so be careful about these problems. Okay, so the next type of problem what we are going to study today is, again, it has little different formula, but it means the same. Again, let us see that problem. In a bivariate data, so what they have given is summation of x minus x bar square is this, summation of x minus x bar square is this, summation of x into x minus x bar into y minus y bar is this, find the coefficient of correlation. There is a small mistake in the problem here. Actually, what the problem should have been here is this should have been y. So just make those corrections. Y. So this is x minus x bar, remember, square is 35, and this is y minus y bar square is equal to 60. Okay, now what is the formula to find out coefficient of correlation? The formula to find out coefficient of correlation, again you need to mug up these formulas, is equal to sigma x minus x bar square, x minus x bar into y minus y bar, divided by, here what is divided by, it is square root of x minus x bar square multiplied by a square root of y minus y bar square. So you need to mug up this formula, just substitute this, you will get 42 divided by square root of 35 into square root of 60. 42 is this, comes from here, and 35 and 60. You have to substitute L. L and L. So 35 into 60. Once you solve this, find out the square root of this, multiply these two both, you will get 45.825 in the denominator. Numerator is 42. When you divide, you get 0.96. So what is your comment? Please tell me the comment. Yes, that is right. What you are thinking. The comment is, it shows positive correlation. Why positive is because the value that we are getting is positive, and very high degree of positive correlation because the value is very close to 1. So your comment is, it shows very high degree of positive correlation. I hope you understood today's problems. These were smaller problems. The only thing that you should be careful about is to understand, and you should by heart these formulas. Once you know these formulas, it becomes very easy for you, because these are mainly substitution only. So with this, we end our today's lecture.